Take your praise. Take your honor. Receive the glory that is presented to you in this house. Thank you, Lord, for this family. A family of kingdom melodies. Thank you, Lord. But I ask that tonight you will give us another level of prophetic dimension. Another level of prophetic unction. Another level of prophetic anointing. So that by the prophetic word, every yoke shall be broken. Every nothingness shall become full. Cause the Holy Ghost to take full control of this meeting tonight. He said, eyes have not seen nor ears have ever heard what you have for your people, but you have revealed it by the Holy Spirit. Speak of God. Please take your seat. Then we just started with an introduction. Today we are going to build some foundations for millennials to take off. You heard in the prayer there will be transfers tonight. You see, your being a millennial has nothing to do with your intellectual knowledge, nor your capabilities. It is the ability of God to make you a millionaire. I read. He said, there was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher, come from God. No man can do these miracles that thou does, except God be with him. Now, the next reading is very important. That's the response of Jesus. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Somehow, the enemy has held the church back from moving forward. And tonight some things will be released. Amen. Jesus said that except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. Now let's go further. You see something wonderful there. Nicodemus said unto him, how can a man be born when he is old? How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter the second time into his mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Two things. There's a vast difference between seeing the kingdom and then entering the kingdom. You make the mistake and you remain seeing the kingdom. You be like spectators in the kingdom, watching football and playing ball. And the game of the football, the world remains in the football. Footballers are billionaires today. They are making money from spectators, people who see, who watch them. A A very good example of seeing the kingdom was like a man who challenged the prophet of God. An army commander. I want you to understand seeing the kingdom of God. The prophet said, tomorrow by this time, there shall be abundance in this nation of Israel. The army commander who is close to the president of the nation said, prophet, do you think this can be possible? Even if the windows of heaven be open. The prophet, out of anger, said, you will see, but you will not participate. Yeah. That means you will see, but you will not enter. That means you will see, but you will not be part of it.
Yeah.
What happened? It happened. The man saw it, and he was dead. He saw it, they trampled over him, and he died. What is an example of seeing the kingdom? Jesus talked about the kingdom and said, the kingdom of God is like a man who died very wealthy, rich. And a poor man, Lazarus, also died. And Lazarus was found in the bosom of Abraham. And the rich man was found in hell. But while the rich man was there, he could see the kingdom of God. But was he part of it? In fact, he could see Abraham and Lazarus and co enjoying heaven wine. And he wanted common water. Common water. People are drinking wine. He wanted water. In fact, he shouted and said, Father Abraham, please let Lazarus, that I used to know on earth, people know you on earth. Let him dip his finger in water and drop it. And Abraham said, there is a gap between us. It's not possible. And he said, you're going to eat, I have brothers on earth. I don't want them to come to where I am, where I can see the kingdom, but I can't be part of it. Abraham said, he said, for that matter, send Lazarus to go back to the earth and tell my brothers not to live the life I live to be here. You know what answer Abraham gave? Abraham said, we can't send anybody from here, but Moses and the prophets are there. Let's read it so that you get it clear. We'll come back to where we stopped. Let's read Luke. Luke chapter 16, verses 27. Then he said, I pray thee therefore, Father, that thou wouldest send him to my father's house. For I have five brethren, that he might testify unto them, lest they also come into the place of torment. Abraham said unto him, they have Moses and the prophets. Let them hear them. The reason why I believe Bishop brought me in here is because for kingdom Melonians to take off strongly, the prophet is needed. Say amen.
Amen.
In fact, some of you, we will force you tonight to be Melonians. By the power of the word of God.
Amen.
This thing about poverty in Africa. Whereas Africa is the richest continent in the world. I don't understand. That every continent is eating from the riches we have, and we are living in poverty. Abraham said there are Moses and prophets, but you know Moses is gone already, so we are left with prophets. But I pray that you will always fall in the hands of a true prophet. Because we have all kinds of prophets, street prophets. We have pocket prophets. We have stomach prophets. You know, we have all kinds of prophets who can see all your problems, but they don't have solution to it. Let's go back to entering the kingdom. Jesus said, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit. I will not have enough time to talk about that, but I'll just give you a little piece. There is a book that I brought called Are You Truly Born Again? Please get it. So that what I'm not able to share, you will get it from there. To be born of water is not water baptism. If you look in Ephesians, it says to be sanctified by the water of the word. To be born of the Spirit is not Holy Ghost baptism. To be born of the Spirit is something that God will release into you. And that is what you need to be able to enter the kingdom. If not, you will see the kingdom, but you will not be part of it. This is a hard thing to share, but it's a fact. You will get more information in that book, because we don't have much time to share. But it has been begging on me to let you know that it is good to be a millionaire, and a millionaire that will finally enter the kingdom. In fact, when you go to the restaurant, you see some chicken rolling in a glass. When you see it, your saliva will change. Yes. But when you see it, have you cheated? When you see it, do you have access to it? That is how the kingdom is. For you to buy that chicken, you must pay. So that when you pay, you can enter into the chicken. So there is vast difference between seeing the kingdom and entering the kingdom. Christians are marching to strategic position to see the kingdom, but tonight you will enter the kingdom.
And you go to church, they will tell you
was going to fall.
And the man had a good idea. Let me chop Paul. God killed him. Is that not so? Can you take something by force from God?
Some of us have the privilege to have conversation with God almost every time we are interested in doing that. You see, if there's a problem, all I need to say is, sir, let's discuss this. And let me tell you, God is interested in having personal conversation with you all. But the problem is that you have been busy for nothing. How many Christians will wait for God to talk? They will talk 1 week. Amen. He's going. Why don't you wait a while? Let God also talk.
Amen.
Why don't you wait a while for God to speak? Look, God has complained that, look, my people are not going to listen to me. And this is complaint he gives to we who are prophets.
Amen.
Sometimes you get up in the night, 12 midnight, you don't need to pray. All you need to sit down and talk with God. Yeah. Just sit down. The Bible said, Isaiah 118, God said, come and let's reason together.
Oh, yes.
God is waiting for you to come and sit before him and reason with him. The problems you're going through, the difficulties you have, the problems you are looking to resolve. He's waiting for you to come and listen with him. Christians have been busy buying and losing. And you know the trouble? Many a time they are buying something they should lose. And they are losing things they should buy. Confusion in the highest order. Actually, I do not know, but I am just buying. How can you buy something you don't know? Maybe the thing must be loose. You are buying. The thing must be loose. You are buying. The thing must be buying. You are losing. Why? You don't understand what you are doing. The servants came and said, Master, all the guests are busy. So the master was angry. And look at what he said. Go to the streets and bring people for the dinner. Do you know the dangerous thing? The guests are Christians who, if we don't take care, at the end of time, Jesus will leave us and take the streets people will take will go to hell and bring them to the banquet. May the Lord have mercy and deliver us. This kingdom we are talking about is important to your life. Yes, God wants you to be a millionaire, but enter the kingdom and be a millionaire.
Yes.
Let us stop this action. You know, I had some good time with Bishop, with Charles, and I was happy with the kind of bending he carries. Let me tell you one thing. There are many bishops that will invite me, even first class, I'll turn it down. Because if your begging for God's word is not true, I'm not interested. There are bishops that are interested in what they get. They don't care about the sheep. They will milk you. But you see, I realize this man is not like that. He has concern for you. He's begging for people. And that is the kind of shepherd God is looking for.
Amen.
You see, as the year comes to a close, there is going to be a shake-up in the body of Christ for the untrue leaders to fall out. And then the true ones will take place.
Yeah.
Tonight there shall be transfer.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Tell the person to get ready for your transfer. Tell the person if you are not ready, move forward. One important thing you need to know is that why will you need the prophet? Why will you need the prophet? Let's go to 1 Kings. 1 Kings 17:1. And Elijah the Tishbite, who was the inhabitant of Gilead, said unto Ahab, as the Lord God of Israel liveth, before whom I stand, there shall be not be dew nor rain this year, but according to my word. The prophet said, but according to my word, his word. Why? A prophet has his own word, and a prophet carries God's word. When a prophet says, thus saith the Lord, that is God's saying. But when a prophet says, my word, that is his word. And somebody will say, ah, how can the prophet say his own word? Yes, he has the power to say his own word. How do we know that? Let's go back to the Bible again. Yes. 1 Kings 19:15-16. And the Lord God said unto him, go return on the way to the wilderness of Damascus. And when thou comest, anoint Israel to be king over Syria. And Jehu the son of Nimshi shall thou anoint to be a king over Israel. And Elisha the son of Shaphat of the Abimelech shall thou anoint to be a prophet in thy room. The room here means office. Now, God was telling Elijah that, look, you want to come to heaven, no problem. But I want you to do some things for me. I want you to put some people in places of authority. Number one, Jehu, and then the other king. But I want you to anoint Elisha, a prophet, to take over your office. You see, your president's office has authority. Is that not so?
Amen.
Every office has authority. And that office word is the power the man occupying the office has. So every prophet has office. Every true prophet, let me say it that way. Every true prophet has their office and the power of their office. So by the true prophet's word, something will happen to your life. I want you to know tonight, something is going to happen to your life. By the word of the prophet's office, something new is going to happen to your life.
Amen.
There shall be transfer tonight. Let me take this last one, then we will start some prophetic action. 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 1 to 7. You know that story so much. He said, the sons of the prophet said unto Elisha, behold, now the place where we dwell with thee is too straight for us. Let us go, we pray thee, unto Jordan, and take thence every man a beam. Let us make us a place there where we might dwell. And he answered, go ye. And one said, be content, I pray thee, and go with thy servants. And he answered, I will go. The people know that this journey we are going to embark, we need the prophet. The project we are going to carry, we need the prophet. So the prophet said, yes, I will go with you. Now look at what happened in the day. So he went with them, and when they came to Jordan, they cut down wood. But as one was felling a beam, the axe head fell into water. And he cried and said, alas, master, for it was old. And the man of God said, where fell it? And he showed him the place. And he cut down a stick and cast it in there. And the iron did swing. A metal axe head broke and fell into river. And the people cried and said, Master, the axe, we borrowed it. And the prophet said, where did it fall in the river? And they said, around here. And the prophet just picked some leaf or stick and threw it there. And the axe head came up. Disproved the law of flotation. Canceled the law of gravity. And then suspended. And if you read, he says, the prophet said, pick it up. Everything that has been borrowed over your life. And that has been lost over your life. Tonight you will pick it up. Tonight you will pick it up. Tonight you will pick it up. Some of you, some things have been lost. Ancestral connections have buried your everything. Tonight you will pick it up. Tonight there will be a prophetic word over your life that will cause you to pick up everything that has been swallowed by any water, by any sea, by any enemy.
Amen.
All I want you to be ready is with your faith.
Amen.
A woman said, that son of David has mercy over me. He said, I did not come but for the house of Israel. The Bible says, the woman persevered. And the disciples told the woman, shut up, woman, you're making noise. And Jesus said to the woman, I can't give you the food or the bread of the children. Then the woman replied back, but when the children eat the bread, the crumbs that fall, the dogs can eat. That is the level of faith I want you to build tonight. It doesn't matter your situation, your place where you are. I want you to build up a persevering faith, a persevering spirit. Look at our sister. She went sleeping in the train station, persevering to take something. Look at that woman with the issue of blood. Look, I can't get into this crowd, but let me make another way. Let me go under the feet of people. If I can just touch the dress of that man, I believe something will happen. Tonight, you better touch some things. Tonight, touch some things. Don't leave here as you can. Don't waste your transport tonight. You should have been sleeping. Don't waste your sleep. Tell somebody, I must take something home. Tell somebody, no matter how difficult, I will take something home. Say, perseverance. It's what I will do tonight. With my faith. Oh, lift the cup of it to me. We are about to take off with the prophetic. Now that you understand, I have an office as a prophet. And for that matter, I have a word from my office. Bishop told you, I'm a prophet to the nations. And that gives you an even better matter. That a man who speaks and affects nations. What is your small problem? You're just a single human being. When I sat on TV and told Ghana that an African will enter the White House, men of God called me, Prophet, are you out of your mind? I said, what are you telling me? I had a dialogue with God and he told me a secret that he has on earth. When I got to America, I was interviewed in front of the White House. And I said, yes, I came to prepare the White House for an African to rule. They said, what? How people were there, they were laughing. If you watch the video, it's funny, they were laughing. I came and said, oh, my brothers and sisters, what you are listening that looks funny, it will come to pass. You will look for me, you will not see me. Today, they are looking for me, but they are not seeing me. On the 31st of October, 2008, the Lord said, hold a video for Barack Obama's success in Ghana. It was on news, every media house of Canada. The prophet is going to hold a video for Obama's night for success.
And all kinds of people came there. People who don't even know Jesus, they came there. Because all they are interested in is that a black man should enter the White House.
And many people thought that if the black man enters the White House, Africans will enter America free. You know Africans have funny thinking, huh?
That if my brother enter, oh, there will be no visa for us again. People came in the whole night. And 12 midnight, they said, prophet, it's your time.
I said, God, what am I going to do? The Lord said, take oil. Call somebody to represent Barack Obama in Ghana now. Give me that oil bottle. So I just turned and looked, and behold, a man was sitting. I called a man who didn't know me. Not knowing the man was the president of African American Association in Ghana. He came with his executive. I called him. I said, sir, do you want to kneel down? He said, yes. He knelt down. I poured the oil on him. I said, Father, tonight, I anoint this man as Barack Obama to take the seat in the White House. Then after that, I made them bring a seat. I made them carry an American flag. I said, congratulations, Your Excellency Barack Obama. Sit in the seat, the throne of the White House. 4 days to the election of America, 21st October, on the 4th, they voted. And it came to pass.
Amen.
If it happened for Barack Obama, tonight it will happen for you. Tonight it will happen for you. The two of them. They are beginning the prophetic. Let's not watch us come behind it. Say them, Father, tonight I transfer the beauty riches, the beauty place that people in America and Europe are messing up. I transfer it into your daughter now for your kingdom. I collect those positions they have been messing up with the world. In the area of beauty, in the area of fashion, in the area of whatever, terror and cold, that they used to honor Satan, I shift that world and place into your daughter tonight.
Oh, yes.
Take it! And manage it to the honor and the glory of Yahweh in heaven. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God bless you. Take your seat. Lift up your hand, Brother James. Two hands. Father, I speak to the spirit man of Brother James. Oh, I command his spirit man. Open up! Open up for God's direction and God's power and God's wisdom and God's knowledge. Now, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Those favors that they are wasting, I'm moving into your son and your daughter. That doors will be opened into nations, governments, financial controllers, mighty, mighty billionaires, for them to be dragged into the kingdom of God. In the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Holy Spirit. Let the people shout, Amen. Lift up your hands. That which has been holding his progress, that which has been keeping him not to move, I remove it now. I remove it now. And I'm moving into another gear, another level of new place of occupation. A place that will move your kingdom further and make his family a glorious and an honorable family. In Jesus' name. Come. Lift up your hands. Let somebody stand behind you. This one, Lord,
that which has been hidden from her, that she will need to know and increase and take off. I open it to her. I release it to her. I give it to her to move it to another level for the kingdom's movement and sake in Jesus' name. Come. So Lord, I touch your servant. Increase grace, increase power to progress in your work, in the ministry. Favor him! That is the new favor! That everywhere you go, men at your command will submit in Jesus' name. Come. Lift up your hands. Even so, Lord, I speak into this one's life. Every holdout, every block, every hindrance, I take them off! And I bring restoration of a lost ground for a new takeoff. In Jesus' name. Amen.
All. Okay, you want to clap? Clap. Four years ago, I was challenged in a media hub. You don't provoke a prophet. They provoked me by saying, I don't know what I'm saying. I'm only receiving them as what? They said, okay, prophet, give us a sign. I said, okay, the sign I'll give is more dangerous. I don't want to. They said, no. I said, let me tell you. It's not about who will be the next president. Let me tell you, even his rulers. The person who will win the election and be the next president, he will not finish his term and he will die. And that is what I am working to make sure it doesn't happen. And oh, people called on the program and insulted me. Mom, did you hear the name of our president? It happened. Somebody will say, but Prophet, why didn't you do anything? I did everything to go to seat of government. And because they didn't allow, it happened. It is not when somebody comes to deceive you and are you not wearing this color of a panties? I didn't know that your color. That your color of your panties has got to do with your life. Does it make sense? And let me tell you, those people who see your problems and they can't do anything, let me tell you, if you want to see, let me show you. I'm a spiritual man. Those Satan's children, they are below standard. You see, when you have eye problems, there's something white on your eye. The eye water that comes to settle. You know it? You know, cats have some, dogs have some. When you go to a native doctor, he can take the cat's food and dog food, put it in water, mix some concoction, give it to you, you wash your eyes. When you see somebody, the person in class, you will read everything about the person. And they will use that to deceive you. You think that is a prophet. No. That is only a stomach man. He wants to take your money and eat. Those people don't have no office. In fact, before I came to South Africa, the media have called me, Prophet, so now what is going to happen to the country? I said, no, I won't talk again. Yes, that is a prophet who has an office. A prophet has authority to change your life. Amen. Oh, prophet, prophesy over me. Let me tell you, the most deadly thing they can do over your life is to prophesy things about you. If they prophesy about you, as a true prophet, let me tell you, when Jacob, the great prophet, made a mistake, and prophesy over his son Judah by saying, the scepter shall not depart from your house. Genesis 49. That was when Satan realized that, oh, now we know it is Judah's house. But Satan didn't know. Satan only knew in Genesis chapter 1 and chapter 2, where God told Satan that the seed of the woman shall bruise your head. But Satan doesn't know where that woman will come from. when that baby will appear. But when Jacob made a mistake and prophesied, because the office of the prophet is privileged to make the mind of God vocalize. Yesterday, you saw me calling people. You didn't see me say something about somebody. Because if I say some good thing about you, Satan now will know that, so that is what this one will be. We will see. The ministry of Satan will increase here over your life. Because I know. That is what the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 16:9, that a great and effectual door is open unto me, but there are many adversaries. How did the adversaries come there? They know there was a gate for you. How did they know that a prophet prophesied for you? But tonight, we will not expose your secrets. We will keep them in you, and we will make sure they are watered to come to fruiting.
Amen.
All you need is a true prophet.
Amen.
All you need is a true prophet. A prophet that can speak a word. And that word will be honored by heaven.
Oh, yes.
That is all you need.
Amen.
Tonight is going to happen over your life.
Yes.
Let all those who are born on Mondays come out fast. Monday borns, come out. You were born on Monday. All of you in the first row, come on. Come on, quickly. Some of you, when God bless you, that's the time you look up to church again. Stretch your hands at the front of your hand yourself. Father, this is the first row of that prophetic word now over their lives. Let that word turn around every negativity in their lives. Every wrong foundations their ancestors have laid. I break it down and raise new foundations by the power of the word and the perfect blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. And I speak into their life a new level, a new transfer of the world in the secret darkness into their life. I speak now, transfer, Lord, into their hands. Wealth and make them potential billionaires. Make them millionaires right now. Let them take what belongs to them. Tonight is your night in Jesus' name. Yes. 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 Yes! Andoro Sikiria Batosota Mayanda Saya. Andiria Kabusote Matandea. Yes! Let it be over. Now! Today is their day and their portion. In Jesus, take your seat. Let the second row come. Leave them there. Come. Lord, this is a second group. I speak over wrong foundations in your life. I paralyze every demonic holdings, every demonic covenants, every demonic altar that are speaking in your life. I address it now. I collapse those investments of your ancestral acknowledgement. I break it tonight and I decree a new life, a new foundation that is laid by the perfect blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, take that new foundation, take that new altar, take that new covenant, and now receive a transfer of wealth. Receive a transfer of wealth. Receive a transfer of wealth. I release wealth from the secret places into these hands. In Jesus' name. Amen. Take your seat. Let the secretary come. Let's do it quickly. Okay, let the next row and the other row join. Two rows now. Step your hands to the front. Father, this is a new level, a new people. We address their foundations, their satanic altars, and covenant of their ancestral home. I transfer wealth into their hands. I take the wealth in the world and put it in their hands. And I command them to take off as new millionaires in the ministry. Remnant International, in Jesus' name. Amen. Take your seats. Let's have all the rows here. All of you to the end. Come. We transfer wealth into their hands. We take the riches in the world, the riches in the secret places, we transfer them into their hands, and we make a decree that they are as new millionaires in this city of Pretoria. In Jesus' name. Amen. Take your seats. Let all of you on the back here, all of you join them. Quickly. Don't leave the babies behind. They might be the solution, not you. Let's hurry up. After this, we have the last one at the back, the group of you left. And the technical man, you will also join them. The cameraman, leave your camera and come. At this moment, it's not camera work. And then you come and then receive your own. Set your hands to the front. Open your hands. If you are holding a baby, just one hand. Don't open your two hands. Don't bother the babies to open their hand. Leave them. Their enemies know better than you. Father, we have cursed these foundations here. We curse every evil foundation in their lives. Ancestral mistakes. Ancestral ignorance. We take it off from their lives. We pronounce in their lives tonight a new foundation, a new altar, a new covenant, a new structure that is to be raised, that will make them new potentials, new melodies, new power control in this city of Pretoria. Let them receive it that which belongs to them. Now take it. Take it. What belongs to you tonight is released from heaven by the prophetic unction. Become new melodies in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please go back to your seat. Leave those lying down. Leave them and go. Hold it. Complete it. Spirit of God, in Jesus' name, come.
That is why they delayed. Oh, she will not hear. Then when the time was so yet up, she became mad in the 7th year or 8th year. And she picked seed for the first time. But she nearly died with the baby. The baby died. I told her, you see, if you force me, it will be dangerous. Now she relaxed. So after 1 year, the womb was fixed in order. Then one day, I just got up and said, honey, do you know something? I said, you're going to give birth to twins, 2 boys. Then she said, oh, is that so? Don't know, it must be 1 boy, 1 girl. I said, the deal has been settled. You want to bring your vision, you are here, you want it. She refused and she was buying baby things, get a boy, get a boy, get a boy. I said, look, I'm waiting for you. The day she gave her, she was eager. Please, doctor, what did I get? He said, you got 2 boys. Hey, this is my husband. And the doctor said, what does your husband do? He told me it's 2 boys and I refused. She came home. She now wants to wear the boy and girl. I said, hey, woman, you can't change anything, you know. Holy, we have prophets room, we have prophetess room, and we have prophesying. Listen, prophets room, prophetess room, and prophesying. What is the prophet room? The prophet is when a man is a prophet. And the prophetess is a woman. And prophesying is anyone that avails he or himself. God will use you to prophesy. Amen. You are going to seek for a contract. You don't need prophet or whoever. You can prophesy and the contract will be held. You have the authority to do that if you know what to do. And what to do is in that book. Yeah. To be born again properly is in the other book. There's another one, the lessons of John the Baptist. In fact, many of you will rise, but a little mistake will let you fall. That is when you take offense over anybody around the bishop or the bishop or the bishop's wife. Taking offense is what called the demotion of John the Baptist. People do not know. In the kingdom, the least is greater than John the Baptist. I'm telling you, get that book and read it, you'll see it. The first time I said it on media in Ghana, men of God called me, hey prophet, you are mad. I said, hold it. When I said open Bible, they opened. They all started to beg me. They said, prophet, we have never seen it. We didn't know. Jesus said it. When John the Baptist sent people from prison to come and ask Jesus, are you the one or we should wait for another? This man is going out of his mind. When Jesus was in his mother's stomach, 4 months, John the Baptist, you were 6 months, your eyes were closed, you were able to identify Jesus. Yeah. Yeah. Your mother Elizabeth testified that when I saw the mother of my Lord, my stomach, the baby, was torn. Now you are a bearded man, you cannot see Jesus. Something is wrong with you. Do you know the secret? Jesus and John the Baptist are first cousins. So John the Baptist jealous Jesus. And for that matter, he took offense. So Jesus, when the disciples came, he said, what did you go to the wilderness to see? Did you go to see a royal? No, of course. You went to see a prophet. A prophet indeed. Among those born of women on earth, there's none greater than John. But I tell you of truth, the least in the kingdom will be greater than him. Because he took offense of me. It is there. Get that book so that you will learn not to take offense over people that are spiritual. Amen. Did you hear that? Yes. It doesn't matter what bishop your father or your mother will do to you. If you make a mistake and take offense, I'm telling you, sometimes you might come and beg, but it will be too late. I'm
telling you. Amen. And that is why that book is there for you. You didn't need to come to Ghana to buy it. I brought it for you to buy. And it is just to cover some cost of printing and to invest in the prophet's office. And also, you see, there's a scripture I was to read, but because of time. If you read 2 Kings 13, before the prophet Elisha died, the king of Israel came to us. He cried, my father, the chariots of Israel and the horsemen. This king didn't know that this is the man who said it originally. Some of you, that is how you are. The way the bishop speaks, when you go somewhere, you want to speak like that. Do you have the anointing the man has? The king didn't know that this is the original man who spoke, my father. The prophet asked him, President, what is the problem? He said, enemies have come to attack Israel. The prophet said, take bow and arrow. And the Bible said, the king took bow and arrow. Then the prophet said, he opened the window and told the king to shoot eastward. That is direction. And the prophet said, and the Bible said, and the man, the king held the arrow. And the Bible said the prophet put his hand on the king's hand to guide him for deliverance, to guide him for success. That is one of the reasons why you need prophets to guide you. But you can't have us every day, no problem. Buy information and know what to do so that you don't need me every day.
Amen.
Any man of God who wants to let you need him every day is a witch. Bishop, am I right? Because they manipulate you. When we say witch, it's not people who drink and eat human flesh. Hello. We have people who are witches and wizards in churches. Oh, some of you men, you are witches in your home. And women, you are witches in their home. You see a man, today he wants to have his wife by him. Haven't you finished? You are delaying the kitchen. Okay, let me come and help you. Have you been helping her? Today you need her, you want to help her. That's a witch. Manipulation is witchcraft. And some of you women, and if you don't buy this one, and you wear talents. You wear talents, then husband or honey. Hello, darling, don't leave me. If you leave, you can leave the house. You can't be in the house and say, leave me. One of the conditions of you being in the house is according to bed duty. So no man is to witchcraft his husband and wife, and no wife is to witchcraft his husband. Manipulation is witchcraft. That's why you must learn to get away from pray for me, pray for me. Learn to pray for yourself.
Amen.
Learn to prophesy over your life.
Amen.
That's why you need information that can make you better. Get those information. There is a CD that is DID, your identity. When you travel outside your country, you have your passport as your identity card, right? But do you know that before there was a passport, you have a heavenly identity? That heavenly identity will take you everywhere. Your commission in Ghana is supposed to process a visa between 4 and 10 days. But I took my visa in 3 hours. Why? I used my heavenly identity. May God give you a heavenly identity.
Yes.
That is why when Jesus was walking with the disciples, he turned and said, who do men say I am? They wanted to know his identity. And Jesus was making sure the disciples know his identity. You must know your identity.
Amen.
Get that CD and listen and know how to get your identity. God cannot give you anything that will not cost you. When David was going to make a sacrifice, a man said, my Lord, there is sheep, there is lamb. He said, no, I will not make a sacrifice that will not cost me. Every time you must think of making a sacrifice that will cost you. The prophet was there. A woman came to the prophet and said, Master, my husband was a man of God, and he died and left dead. May God deliver men of God that are following and will not pay. useless. The prophet said, what do you have?
The woman went and brought loaves and food and tears.
Sometimes you need to follow and come before the Lord, and the Lord will pay that debt and give you essence.
Amen.
Lord, Jesus bless you.